ourselves out long enough, we get in the way. Alright, let's see it. Nice one. Nice one on the Ned. Not too big lengthwise, but chunky. Oh my goodness. Look at that chunk. Apparently he eats a Whataburger too. Short little thing. That might be 14 inches. Might be 14 inches. I'm not even sure it's legal length keeper size, but look at that belly on him. That is funny. I'm gonna call this the Whataburger bass. Oh yeah, I'll give you a mouth shot. He looks real healthy. Alright guys, I love it. The Whataburger football, barely legal bass. Alright, we're gonna release him just like this, ready? And away he goes. Alright, I knew bass number two would come. Perfect little. Alright. Number two. Okay, guys and gals. Probably gonna be the last stop. So we're gonna do an all-out assault on this dock. Got all three poles, got the crankbait, got soft plastics. Kind of excited about this thing being tied up here because fish tend to like that. Trying to see if there's anything under there. Alright. Chartreuse crank first. You really should not come out to Buffalo without a chartreuse crank or a crank of some sort. I prefer chartreuse simply because it can be seen by the fish really easy in the water. This is heavily stained water. Obviously, you want something the fish is gonna see. We'll start out with a crankbait. Honestly, yeah, there we go. Got one. Okay. Gonna try to stay calm. Yeah, he was trying to outrun the old crankbait, but we got one. Look at that. Tiny, 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 tiny little fish. That's hilarious. We call him Mr. Ambitious, I guess. Tiny little dude. Sign of a healthy fishery is what I always say. Okay.